So everybody these days is into IoT, Internet of Things, and asset tracking, and wondering what the latest technology is. And you might think it's RF, radio frequency, but it's not. We're going to be talking about Bluetooth technologies coming right up. Okay, so when you think about asset tracking, we think of RF tags and things like this, but we're talking to Stelios here at Telstra. Have I pronounced that right?
Yes, that's right. Yeah.
And Stelios, you're a product manager for what sort of products?
Great. So, hey everyone, Stelios. I'm the product manager of Telstra Track and Monitor, Track and Monitor, yeah. So this is Telstra owned and built. It's our end-to-end IoT asset tracking solution.
Great.
So look, it's quite a unique solution for us. We're effectively leveraging Telstra's various network technologies. So we can talk about a bit about that today, which is really exciting.
But we've got some toys on the table.
And we do have toys, yeah.
So look at these. We've got some solar powered asset trackers that we're going to hear about. And we've got these little ones that we can stick on products, and we've even got these things, which you can hang on even smaller products. So tell us a little bit about the technology and how does all of this differ from RF?
Yeah, no worries. So look, I think the reason we do need these network technologies is that assets are always moving.
Yep.
And I think if you mean traditional network technologies like RF, they only give you the last known location or the last time you scanned a particular asset. So what we've had to really start to do is think outside the box and how we can leverage these network technologies to understand what assets are on the move and how we can improve the visibility when an asset's on the move. And you mean the way you also have to do that is there's no single solution for how you solve for that. You do have to use a blend of different types of network technologies.
Okay.
And that's really where Telstra's thought to bring its expertise, especially from a network technology level.
So tell us, I was fascinated, we were talking the other day about this, that where does the Bluetooth bit come in? So was it right that you're using mobile phones to create a Bluetooth network?
Yeah, that's right.
So this sounds spooky, so tell us how that works.
Yeah, no worries. So look, I think the obvious dilemma that we've had to solve for from an asset tracking space is battery life.
Yep.
So if you think of your everyday iPhone or your Samsung Galaxy, if you let that thing run hot, it's probably going to die in battery in anywhere between 2 and 3 days.
Yep.
Even some of us, even 24 hours.
Yep.
So the thing that we've had to really start to uncover is how do we get the most amount of battery life at the lowest possible cost? Because as we know, and you said earlier, asset trackers have existed, but they've tended to be at quite a high cost. So what we've looked to do is we've looked to build out a crowdsourced Bluetooth mesh network.
Okay.
And so, and obviously people will say, well, look, Bluetooth's only got 30 meter distance, and that's why you've needed to build out this network of moving beacon points, which can act as part of that. And I think probably just why Bluetooth, because that's obviously a really important part. If we think of different types of network technologies and the amount of battery they drain, so we think of Bluetooth versus Wi-Fi versus mobile or cellular coverage. The equation I like to use for battery consumption is Bluetooth's a grape, Wi-Fi's a mango, cellular's a watermelon.
Oh, okay.
And it kind of follows that.
And that's the consumption.
And that's the battery consumption. And the simplistic way of thinking about it is, it's how far you need to send a signal.
Yeah.
So with Bluetooth, you're sending a signal 30 meters away.
Yeah.
Obviously then with cellular technologies, it can be kilometers away. So we've had to solve that battery dilemma, and that's why we've looked at Bluetooth. So when you start to picture that, this little Bluetooth tracker here with a Bluetooth beacon every 2.6 seconds, it can get to 5 years battery life.
Wow.
If you were to think of the solar tracker, if it was to not see the sun, with one track a day, you'd only get to one track every hour, it'd only get to 4 months. So that's you think cool, 4 months versus 5 years, you do need Bluetooth.
Even if winter is coming, this will last four months.
It will. Yeah. So that's what we're trying. And so how have we done it is probably the next question. So we've looked to leverage a variety of Telstra's assets to build out this Bluetooth mesh network. So probably the first and obvious one, which we see all around the place, is our payphones.
Yep.
We've turned each of our payphones into a Bluetooth finding point.
So hang on, there's going to be people watching thinking, what, payphones? We're going to be talking about phone books in a minute.
Yeah.
So I mean, do you have a lot of payphones still?
Yeah.
Or is it because of Australian geography that you have them in remote areas?
Yeah, we still have them because we still have that obligation to service the payphones as part of our universal service obligations. But what we've looked to do with each of those payphones, and there's just shy of, I think, 4,500, which are enabled with this. But if a Telstra Bluetooth tag goes past one of the payphones, we're able to register the location of the unit
Excellent.
Or the tag. Okay. So that's the first piece, and it is on you mean on a rough assumption, you think, 4,500 across Australia's large geographic landscape. That's not that much. But what's kind of interesting with our payphones is they are in kind of central locations. So especially with the Bluetooth unit, you can start to infer a lot based on the distance an asset may have travelled based on where our payphones are. So can you think of shopping centres, regional centres, they usually have a payphone. So what we sometimes notice with the units is they may jump between suburbs and then you can actually say, hey, it's gone from here to here to here just from the payphone network, which is quite useful.
Clever.
So that's the first piece.
So payphones. What other part?
The second piece is we've looked to build out a similar proposition to some of our other competitors around the ability for consumers to be able to locate their devices. Yep. So if we know with iOS and iPhone, we've got
where's my phone.
Yep. So we've looked to build a similar functionality into our Telstra 24/7 app, which is the account management app our consumer customers use to pay their bills, monitor their data usage.
So I have used it.
Yeah. So within that, we've got a functionality called Device Locator. So customers who opt into location permissions, as part of 24/7, we can then use their device as a Bluetooth finding point.
So let me just clarify this. So all the people who've opted into this program, and there could be hundreds of thousands or millions of them, basically their phones become part of your Bluetooth network.
Correct, that's right.
How smart is that?
Yeah, and look, it's actually, the interesting part of it is it has been a very complex and timely exercise to do it, because obviously a lot of people on the video who are watching this will be thinking, well, you're gonna start draining batteries.
And so, good point.
And that's what, and so look, we've had a tremendous development team here at Telstra where, for the past 12 months, we've been testing that with our internal staff. Yep. So it's part of our consumer proposition, which fellow team members of mine are working on, called Telstra Locator. Yep. We ran an internal staff trial of 3,000 people to test this exact concept out. So
What was the result?
Yeah, and look, it's just because it is complex technology, so we have to do a lot of things around how the device scans for Bluetooth units, how it uploads. But the net effect of that was, with this continuous feedback that we got, following like kind of a continuous improvement methodology, we're able to refine. And then when we eventually got it and launched into market, we knew that we'd be comfortable with it.
Very good.
So that's the first one. So we've got 24/7 now. So we've got, and at the moment, we're working right now to build out heat maps and things we can share with our customers. But the rough figures we're seeing right now is anywhere between 500,000 and 1,000,000. Devices or unique devices reporting locations per month.
And if you're watching this from overseas, we're talking a population of 22 million, so that's really good coverage.
It is really good coverage, And
so you may be thinking of the next question, I certainly am, is how bleeding edge is this? Is anyone actually using it?
Yeah, so look, we're currently, I think with the Bluetooth solution which we only launched last month, we've got around 20 to 30 customers currently trialing with it.
So what sort of companies are they? You probably can't share the names.
I can't share the names, but look, it's a bit of everyone. So we've got transportation companies, construction companies, we've got quite a few come in, especially with the Bluetooth technology.
That would make sense.
Contracting agencies,
I can think of a lot of our consulting clients who could use this, utility companies, they have
tools, everything,
generators and transformers and all those sorts of things, lift companies with all their spares.
And look, it's kind of a unique proposition too, because one of the biggest pieces of customer feedback we've had is, IoT, to even get a trial up and running, you need $10,000, $20,000, $30,000, $40,000. And what we've especially developed with these Bluetooth units is we sell them in trays of 20. We've actually done the turn, we sell them in slabs. So, the best part is
you can buy slabs
of these. Yeah. So look, you can buy each unit's $49. We sell the slab for around $1,000. And then the monthly service fee, which includes your mobile app and web portal access, as well as your API access, if you want to do ERP or system integrations, $1.50 per month per device.
Wow.
So even think.
Yeah. So people watching this might be thinking, hang on, I work in mining and we've got all these assets all over the place and spare parts, we don't know where they are. These are really cost-effective solutions.
It is. And look, I think the biggest part for us is going to be is, the you share, we share model. So as different enterprises come on board, because we also locate these anonymously, as a customer, a transport logistics company, you'll build your own Bluetooth network, but you'll get the benefit of the other customer's Bluetooth network.
So everyone who's basically using these gets to share everybody else's network. So
correct.
The network spreads. Yeah.
I think the next question I have is, how is it anonymous then? And I think, look, I can't give away too many details around the technical, because that's where the smarts are, but what we can say is that at a device level, when a mobile device has our application installed that scans these tags, we're only scanning for Telstra devices. And then we do the association at a cloud level, where everything is more secure.
So of the people, I know it's early days, but of the companies that are trying these out, what sort of benefits or advantages are they finding?
Definitely. Look, and I think probably to change a bit of tact, I'd want to talk a bit about the solar tracker.
Oh, okay. This one, we're sitting with these.
And obviously they're not as nice, and I think these are a bit cooler.
These are cute, but these are big and ugly.
So look, just a bit about the solar tracker. This is the device that operates on our mobile network.
Okay.
So if we think of Telstra's mobile network, or you mean our 4G network, we've got around 2.5 million square kilometres of standard voice coverage.
Okay.
But with this device actually operates on our low-powered wide area network, which is our Cat M1 network. And that's got an extra 500,000 square kilometres of coverage.
Wow.
So this one's on 3 million square kilometres of coverage, and one of the largest IoT
networks. What proportion of Australia is that?
Oh, good question.
Don't know. Comment below if you can work that out.
But it is a good question. So this device, solar powered, so it can last up to 4 months on a single solar charge, assuming up to one report per hour.
Yeah.
And its standard tracking frequency is up to once per minute when moving, and once every 4 hours in stationary. So this is going to give you really good visibility as moving assets. So we currently have a customer of ours, one of Australia's largest privately owned transport logistics company, SCT Logistics, in Victoria. And they're using this to track their rail wagons, their trailers, their shipping containers, and their refrigerated containers.
Yep.
And look, and for them, it's been quite a journey, because they've really been kind of one of our large first moving customers, and they've really helped to inform the solution and given us some tremendous feedback around how we can make this really work for customers. But look, some of the key benefits for them and how they've painted it to us is that each trailer can be worth anywhere between $75,000 and $150,000. You'd lose one of those trailers
You might be wondering, how do you lose a trailer? It happens in these very big transport operations, and particularly in a country like Australia with sort of very remote operations.
It is, and so look, for them, the simple ROI is if we assume even a 4% stock loss per year on a fleet of 1,500 assets, that's $4 million.
Yeah.
So and so you can feel it quite quickly. So for them, the basic benefits have been asset visibility, but then all the other things that come from it is just optimized prices. You're no longer looking for where these assets are, and then probably the next step is the proactive monitoring, so being able to know where assets are now, how they're moving around. You can infer different things.
Yep.
And then for them, look, I do think the benefits are going to continue to flow on. As some of the viewers may have heard earlier, as part of our solution, we give customers both a web portal and a mobile app, but we do also give them the API for the data. And becomes really interesting is you can feed that data into your own systems, data lakes, and start to do some really cool reporting. So even one you could set up is with the data source from the tracker and the data source from your inventory management or your delivery management system, you could mesh the two together and do a notification system to your customers. Your trailer's arriving. So this is a really great solution, solar powered, big assets, trailers, shipping containers, rail wagons. Yeah. I think it's really gonna start to transform the game here in Australia.
Excellent. And is this sort of technology being used overseas at all?
Look, from what we understand with the Bluetooth stuff,
Tell us that Telstra are the leaders in the world.
Yeah, and look, so I think from a telco standpoint, we've spoken to a lot of telcos around the world, and I think we've taken kind of a strategic market leader position with our Bluetooth finding network, so we haven't seen something similar around the world.
Yeah.
And look, there are obviously competitors like Tile and Tracker who use Bluetooth, but from a Telstra standpoint, we believe we're taking a market position on this. And I think the most exciting part is it's only going to scale more.
Yeah.
So we're going to continue to add more and more different types of Bluetooth finding points, and it's probably going to be kind of an exponentially driving effect as more customers come on board, bring more devices. It'll just continue to build and grow out.
That's awesome. So if people are interested in these things and they want to find out more, it's obviously not available on Amazon. Where do we send them?
Customers are able to direct to our website, www.telstra.com/asset-tracking.
Yep.
So on there, there's a nice little inquire now form. All those come through to our
That's
team,
great.
And we're happy to get on the phones and just start to work through a solution for you.
And I should add, before we close off this video, there is no commercial relationship between myself and Telstra. I just thought these were fascinating and the technology is fascinating, and I think it's a story worth sharing. So we'll have to catch up soon and hear about how it's going. That's great. Thank you for sharing all that information. Hope you enjoyed that. Now, you know how it works on this channel. If you found that of value, do hit like, do share, do please comment below, because I'll get this gentleman to answer all your questions. And we look forward to seeing you on the next video. And if you're not already subscribed, make sure you do subscribe, because we have new videos coming out every Wednesday. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks, Stelios.
Thank you.